Thank you for tuning in to Unchurched Christian Ministries. I'm your host, Dedric Hubbard, and today we're going to talk about the cure for Corona. The cure for Corona. And early in the week, God gave me a revelation concerning the Corona crown. And there was a couple of revelations that I released that were in there that people wanted me to be more thorough or bring a better understanding of those revelations. So as I was meditating on how to do that, the Holy Spirit said, just call it the cure for Corona. Because what we fail to see as believers, that number one, this is not no just no ordinary disease or virus that you come in. It just showed up. It just showed up. Reading the Bible, what they put you in the mind of? When God spoke a word for the earth to be formed, the earth just showed up. Showed up. So we got to realize this title here, the cure for Corona, is that the reason there is so much confusion, there's so much panic, there's so much disorganization, is because a lot of the people that believers believe in and have spent their life in knowing God, listen to these people, they have no clue what's going on. They're lost. And most of them, in an effort to save face, they're coming out with outlandish revelations. And if you really listen to the revelation, I hope you pay attention to what I'm about to say, but if you can tell when a revelation for God, God ain't told no preacher to just pray. All through the Bible, when an epidemic hit the land, when a famine hit the land, when God did something in the land, he gave instructions. He told you what to do. What did he tell Moses? He said, I want you to build this ark. And he gave him instructions on how to build an ark. Then he told him who to let in the ark. And then when he got through, if you read the text, it said God closed the door. So a lot of y'all listening to these leaders and these prophetic voices, and they telling y'all, God telling y'all to pray, they are outright lie. They don't hear God. They don't know what's going on. So what God allowed me to do, we're just gonna see. I hope I can help somebody, you know, really understand how the prophetic and the apostolic operates. Because y'all done wasted all y'all money going to these school of the prophets and, you know, these prophetic affirmations and these people that came in for 2 or 3 days and they gonna teach y'all a little something and then they gonna say, oh, you activated. Why you ain't hearing nothing if you activated? Why God ain't telling you nothing? Why you searching Facebook and Twitter and Instagram for prophetic words? Aren't you a prophet? Now, number one, that's what's wrong. Because it's so many gifts, prophetic gifts, apostolic gifts, that have went the way of Baal, no one is really hearing God for the people. Even me, when this first started, I was on my social media accounts. I said, "Where Eckhart at? Where Brian Kahn? What Stevenson? What Ferguson? What Juanita Bynum? What T.D. Jakes? Huh? What Mike? What Michael Moore or whatever his name is? Jensen Franklin? I'm laughing." And the Holy Spirit hit me. He said, when you get through clowning the people, I'm going to give you the revelation what to release to your people. So a lot of y'all who don't know me, maybe just came on some of my social media account, y'all just gonna hop on here and watch because you want to see what I got to say because it got corona in it. That in itself can show you just a prophetic whore. Anything that you see prophetic, you run to it. That's why God is allowing this to happen. The church and the world is whoring after a prophetic. And y'all getting just what y'all will get. They go in. They put that thing in you, release that semen in you. You pay them, and they going on about their business. Cure for corona. So God gave me five things to really talk about based on that first YouTube video I did. Number one. Oh, let me get back to it. So when you prophetic people. People with that with an understanding of the prophetic that should tell y'all this if they didn't know. When something happens and it affects the world, it should immediately catch a prophet's eye. When it catch a prophet's eye, if you connected to an apostle, apostle, what's going on? The apostolic should give you the order in which whatever mishap happening, because the apostolic is all about putting it in order. The prophetic got to set it right. But watch this. Y'all got all these people called chief apostles, doctor chief apostle, chief is of apostle. You got people calling themselves ambassadors, all this title foolishness. But when you run in their page, what they telling y'all? God telling us tell y'all to pray. They ain't hearing from God. Because when something of this nature happens, God is not going to kill innocent people. God is not going to affect innocent people. When Noah built that ark, Noah was preaching while he was building the ark. I can imagine Noah telling them to repent or what's going to happen. Everybody laughing and this and that and that and that until that water started coming down. Then they want to run to Noah. Call your chief apostle and ask him what's going on. Or maybe a lot of y'all already seen your chief apostle. They told you to pray. I said it this morning on a Facebook video. The leader of any congregation, you should be the first line of defense for anything that happened on this world. And if they can't come to you, watch this. What did the Bible say? You need to have somebody who's the bishop of your soul. You need to be working for God. So when you got a leader and they supposed to be in this prayer with God and something of this magnitude happens, your leader should tell you what to do. They should have a word for you. Y'all know what's going on now. Y'all get modernized. I call it modernized because we go back to Katrina or whatever that hurricane was. What did Paul Morton do with that big old church? Paul Morton took his family. He took the money. He took the jet that y'all time paid for, and he flew to Atlanta. Now, everybody in his congregation, guess what happened to him? Boy, there's some good stuff here. Don't get modernized. So y'all got all y'all faith in these people behind this pulpit, and the only thing they got for you is a word is to pray. But watch this. They closing churches down. And they telling, but they making sure you sending your tithes. What the hell? Watch this. They sending out this little thing somebody typed up talking about your pastor ain't never a pastor in a pandemic before, so if they close the church, please don't do this. And some, I didn't even read it all because it's hogwash. Because if they can't make it from a virus, what happens if we believe this Bible and the rapture start to happening and people start leaving here? What your pastor going to do then? So that's why I say it's hogwash. You know what God's showing you? The church ain't prepared for nothing. Nothing. The cure for corona. The first thing that happened that a prophetic eye should have took note of is the hand washing. Hand washing. Why is so important that you wash your hand? Yeah, because see, watch this. When you prophetic and the apostolic, when you hear something in the natural, you got to make it make sense in the spiritual, and then God will begin to tell you what's going on. So you Bible scholars, when you heard of hand washing, you know what the first thing should have came to y'all mind? You know what God told me? He said, Dedric, he said, even though they don't see it, he said, that brazen altar is still there. Y'all know what the brazen altar is, didn't it? That's when you had to come before this altar that was built, and the priest had to wash their hands and wash their feet before they went into the holy of holy. Because when you went in there and you went clean, you died. He said, it's a lot of leaders and people coming into my presence filthy. Strange fire is what I just heard. You filthy. You homosexual. You having illicit sex. You're peeing all on each other. You screwing women in the butt. Y'all out of hand. But then you want to stand up there, God love everybody. He said they filthy. You're prostituting for money. You got women preachers sleeping with men preachers just to get on the pulpit for a sign. I know who you is. He said they filthy. Hand washing. So what's this? The first cure, when it's over with, a lot of y'all, you got to stop going in the presence of God with these. See, the reason that they can still hear the voice of God and still be unclean is because, watch this, because God desires to save everybody, he got to use who got the attention of the people. But when you get a worldwide epidemic that affects the world, the second thing, apostles, you should understand, God is changing guards for real. Y'all say that all the time. The only reason God would change God, and you'll know he's changing guards, is when something happened that affects the world, because he wants the world to take notice. This virus ain't for the world. This virus for this church. Next thing I talked about was social distancing. You know what a prophet should have said? When you understand social distancing, your prophetic anointing, a lot of y'all need to go get y'all money back and come see Brother Hubbard, because they did gave you a piece of paper, took your money, and taught you something generic. Social distancing should have came to a prophet, and you know he should have. That means God is calling the church into an hour of reflect, a time of reflection, which means you got to look back. Not only where you came from and see how much you've grown, but you got to look back and see if you missed any connections. See, a lot of y'all, because you weren't mature when you started ministry, you heard about somebody from somebody that didn't like somebody, and you missed a connection. That's why your ministry ain't where it's supposed to be. You missed a connection. So you got to reflect on what you meant. Who did I treat wrong, God? Who should I have connected with that I didn't connect to? Also, it's a time of repentance. God said, Dedric, they took the grace and mercy for granted. Y'all out here whoring, sleeping with same sexes, but then y'all want to come on Facebook and get behind the pulpit, and you want to talk about the goodness of God and his blessing, and you need repentance. The Bible said, put your gift on the altar. It's a lot of y'all preaching with unforgiveness in your heart. I know some of you still mad at me for things I done said or done. Just because you avoid people don't mean you forgave people. Time to repent. You got to get on your face for real. See what God was showing me. We got so comfortable with grace and mercy, we think we can go out there and screw this woman, screw that man, screw this, and we can dibble and dab in homosexuality, and then we get up and say, God, forgive me. We lay on the altar, we cry at night, and then we think we can go back in the presence of God. Your hands dirty, you need to wash them. Social distance. It's a time of refocus. A lot of y'all got off track. You done got married. You done got this man, this woman, or this woman and this man for y'all same sex. That ain't of God. I don't care what the Bible says, abomination. You can't make me accept a homosexual preacher. Because the word say God don't change not. So if God call it abomination, you telling me God love everybody. God say he, if it's abomination, that means God don't love it. Refocus. Y'all done got a little following. You done got a building. And you got off track with God. You got to refocus. Next, realignment. A lot of you, watch this. A lot of you get God. I can truly say God gave you a ministry. But what happened, you want to sound like the people that was popular. So you went, you deviated from the assignment God gave you because you want a following. You want them coins. You want some money. If God gave you a ministry and you wrote down what God said, you need to go back to those papers and you need to look at the vision God gave you for your ministry, and you need to make sure that you didn't deviate from that ministry. See, social distance to the world means keep away from people. So social distance in the prophetic means God wants you to come back to him. Next thing is replacement. The reason why, hear me good, I have nothing against people that's out there preaching now. As sure as I know I hear the voice of God, he said, Dedric, you make sure that you tell them the reason the mainstream voices with platforms are not hearing what's going on, he said, because I have replaced them. And the problem is because you believe in these people for so long and they got a platform, the people that God need to speak in this season can't get to the platform because all of them is hogging it out. They doing it for money, but you want to do it from the heart. So as long as you give them an ear, God cannot speak to his people. The Bible says, before God comes back, he has to turn everybody back to who? Him. Watch this. The Elijahs can't get to the platform because the spirit of Balaam got all the prophets up there in place. You got to stop going and getting these people paying them $5, $10, $20,000 a minister. You know what these Elijah want? Write it down and hear me. All they want is a place to stay and a platform to preach. Everything else come natural. Y'all inviting people in because you want a crowd. The people I mentor, I tell them all the time. When you invite people in to preach that's popular, you're going to get a crowd. They're not coming to hear you. They come to hear that preacher. So when that preacher leaves, guess what? The crowd leaves. If you can't build your ministry on your own voice, ain't no need of you minister. Stop inviting people that can attract a crowd and invite people that can deliver. These people been replaced. Now all they in it, you know what they in it for? To keep the lifestyle that they have gotten for so many years. That's what they in it for. They can say, God, watch this. What the Bible say? Even Satan say he transfer into an angel of light. Y'all know how it go. Some of these people just been, they been used by Satan. They're an angel of light because he know that they got their ear. But when you shut them down on these platforms, when y'all stop inviting them to preach, then you'll see where their heart really is. A lot of them just still preaching because they like the lifestyle that they got. Next thing they talk about is touch points. Oh, it's good now. If you were prophetic, you know what touch points is in the spirit? That those are areas of improvement in your life that God say he got to touch in this season, in these next 2 months. In other words, he got to kill it at the root. So if you still sleeping around on the side, he got to touch that. If you still dibbling and dabbling with the same sex like a man or woman, he got to touch that. If you still around here lying, stealing, whoremongering, adultery, he got to touch that. If your self-esteem still low, if you still proud, he got to touch that. Oh, it's a cure for the corona. You got to come back to God. See, watch this. God told me, and this leads to the fourth thing. When he told me, he said, Dietrich, when you stop clowning there, I'm going to give you the revelation. He said, I want you to look up the word corona. Everybody thinks it's the bill. So when I looked at the word corona, he says two definitions. I want you to put those in that revelation. I want you to make them understand what I'm saying. The first definition of corona is defined as a crown, a diadem, D-I-A-D-M. Y'all look this up. But for y'all who understood that, do y'all remember 2-3 years ago these prophetic men and women started coming out with these diadem conference? And what God said, he said they didn't understand what they were doing. You was invoking the presence of God. That's why this virus happened, because you got people going to look up some of what it means in the Hebrew and the Greek, and you try to make it out of conference without fully understanding the significance of what it means to God. So all you that had these diadem conferences, if you a prophet or apostle, I know 2 or 3 of them in Birmingham that had them kind of conference. You should have known what corona meant if you were really listening to God. Because had you studied the word, the dean leads back to corona. So if you had that conference these last 2 years, and y'all know who I'm talking about, you should have known what this meant. But that lets you know they wouldn't listen to God. They just want to sound holier than everybody else. Crown. You know what that meant? That means God trying to tell y'all, this my virus. I got to wake these people up. That brings it in. So all y'all who saying, so all y'all who listen to leaders and said God told you to pray, they're a lie. Because God brings about things like this to get the people to humble themselves. So if your pastor, if your chief apostle, if your chief prophet told you that God told you to pray, I'm telling you, they didn't hear the voice of God. So all them people y'all listen to on YouTube and Facebook that said God told y'all to pray, they lying. The dean, crown, corona. God said, this is my virus. So watch this. So cause what's going to happen? So watch this. This God virus. When you pray God word against what he doing, you fighting with God. Y'all ain't going to win this. Psalms 9:1, my butt. What I told y'all this morning, Psalm 9:1 got a qualifying word, and that's why it's not going to work for most of y'all. It said, he who dwells. Look up the word dwell. Dwell means to live in. Okay, so if you were living in God while you shacking with your boyfriend, while you shacking with your girlfriend, while you sleeping with three and four different men, while you commit adultery, you ain't dwelling in God then. But now that a virus that came upon the earth, you want to dwell in God with Psalms 91, it ain't working. Because the word got to be a lifestyle to work. Y'all just, you know what y'all doing? It's like saying your ABC. He who dwells in the secret place. Y'all might be doing it in secret, but Psalm 91 ain't working for y'all. I told y'all a year ago. I said, y'all better change what y'all doing. God is no longer in the defense, and he in the offensive. What's the offensive? God got to protect his name by any means necessary, because you have allowed leaders to play with God's name. You have allowed prophets to say God said when he didn't say it. God got to protect his name. So Psalms 91 is a defensive posture. You got to go to the offensive. What's the offensive posture? You got to find them scriptures say, God, let your enemies be scattered, because a lot of y'all behind these pulpits are God's enemy now. You like the world so much. You an enemy with God. So God is on the offense. He's not on the defenses. So Psalm 91, I'm here to tell you, sure, I hear the voice of God. Psalm 91 is null and effect as long as this virus is going on. Y'all better find out how to repent and get on God's side. I'm with God. I was telling a friend about this earlier. She said, I was laughing when you said that in the first video. Because I told her, I said, when you got a relationship with God, he said, God knows how I am when I know he ain't talking to certain people. I make fun of him. Did he chastise me? No. He said, when you quit clowning him, he said, I'm going to give you a revelation to release. Because the people who I mentor, the people who God ain't telling you nothing. I said, no. But you know what God told me? He said, really, I couldn't tell you then because you were too caught up clowning. Oh, I was having ball. I was out there. Oh, y'all bought that book, Prayers That Rout Demons. Why the coronavirus ain't moving? You got a chief apostle. They say they shift the atmosphere. Why they ain't shifting this coronavirus? Oh, I was clowning. He said, when you quit clowning, I'm going to give you something to say. Next thing about corona, you know what it is? He said, it affects the upper respiratory part of the body. You know what that means? Your breath, Holy Spirit. Y'all grieving the Holy Spirit. Lord have mercy. The Holy Spirit can't say what it want to say because some of y'all in it for the money. So when the Holy Spirit tells you what to say, you change it so you can be popular with the people. Upper part, upper respiratory is affected. Your breathing, which what does it mean? You affecting the Holy Spirit because a lot of y'all preaching for money. Every video on that YouTube, that social, the first thing you see is some Cash App me, PayPal me, sewing me. I've been doing this for 12 years. Ain't nobody seen me put up no Cash App me, PayPal me, sew me. I have plenty of people. Well, I used to have plenty. I still got people that support my ministry. I used to have plenty, but as they grew up, and I taught them and trained. They move on. So you got to take your money, which I understand that. But why every time you got to do a video, it got to be Cash App me? You charging for the word of God? Just let it know. I thought the price already been paid. Now, don't get me wrong. When you get into stuff like teaching people class and anything that takes time and one-on-one and this and that, I can understand charging a little money here and there. But just to get on here and release a revelation, I was looking at something yesterday. This man and his wife got this kingdom ministry. Lord have mercy. But to join the little page they got, they want you to answer all these questions. I said, well, why would he send me this? And I'll join no groups anyway. But I was looking at it. If you kingdom, that means everybody invited. I ain't got to answer no questions. If you move by the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit tell you what's going on. Why I got to ask a question to join the kingdom? The Bible says, seek you first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness and things will happen. So if you're about the kingdom and I'm seeking the kingdom, why I got to ask the question to get in the kingdom? All I got to live right and show righteousness. Listen here. Number five. Cure for corona. Repentance. See, because y'all taking the grace of God for granted, you around here sleeping around with somebody's wife, and then you come back and lay on your knee, God forgive me, and then you go back up and lead the song for the choir. That ain't the kind of repentance he's talking about. He's talking about changed behavior. So if you can sin, turn around, repent, and then go right back to that sin, you ain't delivered. Y'all stop getting in front of these people and you nasty. Your hands ain't clean. See, when you don't understand the call of God on your life, you take your life for granted. When you don't know the power that you have in you, then your life mean nothing to you. See, God allowing this virus, among other things, if he got to get the church attention. It's too much playing. You got to be very aware of what you're doing and what you're going through. Some of y'all still a part of ministries because of blind obligation. When he saved me and I was about to die and I was about to commit suicide and I ain't had any eat. I had a lot of people that I was obligated to. But I understood something. The what God wanted me to do, I couldn't do around the place I was in. A lot of y'all stuck. God done told you to move. I can't afford it. God confirmed it to me. When he told you to move, that was the confirmation. Let me help somebody out. I was staying in Birmingham, Alabama, and God was calling me in the ministry. The first thing he told me to do was move to Atlanta. I was sitting there worrying about moving to Atlanta, and I'm listening to people saying, ooh, Atlanta high, this and that, and the Holy Spirit spoke. He said, if you got to think about how much it costs to move to Atlanta, he said, don't even move. I stopped listening to them people. 2 days later, I got a friend that I guess they still stay in Atlanta. They say, hey, I'm finna move to New York, but I still got a lease on my apartment. You want to move here? All you got to do is pay rent and the bills. Went to Atlanta. Preaching in Atlanta, met a guy in Omaha. Y'all used to, he used to be with me with a minister on the time, white guy named Woody. He wanted me to come up to Omaha to preach. I went up to Omaha to be at a conference for him. When I got to Omaha, I said, man, it's a nice city. I wouldn't mind living here. He said, you want to move here? I said, yeah, I would. But I said, but man, I ain't got no money. I'm telling you, like, I said, I ain't got no money. I stayed in that hotel room about 3-4 days, maybe a week. Woulda picked me up, took me around to an apartment. He said, huh, here your keys. Just pay the rent. My credit was bad. They paid the deposit. First month rent. Put food in the refrigerator. Bought me some furniture. I'm trying to help y'all out. See, when God tell you to move, watch this. Your provision ain't going to come till you get where he tell you to go. So while you sitting, waiting on confirmation, the confirmation was when he told you to leave. So the reason you struggling where you at, and I don't know how I got on this, but I know he told me, the reason you struggling where you at is because your provision where he told you to go. Don't be like, Don't be like Abraham over there in Hebrews. It talks about, it said Abraham was walking around in his blessings. Just to paraphrase, Abraham was walking around in his blessings, but didn't know what his blessings was because he was looking for something that showed God. He was the God in his own blessing, because we made after the image of God. So Abraham didn't even really fully accept his blessings because he looking for something supernatural, and he was the supernatural. Some of y'all need to change ministry. You need to change leaders. You need to change mentor, because you know you done outgrown them. But the people that you need to listen to, the reason you don't want to go is because they'll hold you accountable, and they won't let you get in your mess. The people I mentor, they'll tell you in a minute, Brother Hubbard, pick up that phone, and I see an inbox, I send a smiley face sometime, or sometime I send that mad face or that frowning face, and they know he finna call in a minute. Because watch this. That was one of my pet peeves when I was in church sitting under leadership. I said, this man or this woman hear the voice of God, why am I still sinning and they ain't saying that to me? Why I'm sinning and they ain't saying that to me? That got to me. So when God brought me to a place of ministry, you can't live any kind of way and want Brother Hubbard to teach you. Because Brother Hubbard can't live any kind of way and hear God for you. So watch this. If you sinning and your leader don't know you sinning, that ain't your leader. Because a leader's job is to protect the sheep. That's a cure for corona. But y'all got to be willing to go the distance. Get y'all money at these banks. I was telling a girl today, I said, I forgot the way they put it, but over there in Italy, it's something connected to the worldwide banking system. And it happened a couple years ago when something happened in the banking system, and they wouldn't let nobody draw no money out, even though they had it in there. They'll let you get so much. Y'all better get y'all money at this bank, because watch this. If this really got as serious as they said it to be, and you locked in, do you know the bank can close down and you can lose all your money? Y'all better get you some pit bulls, some Rottweilers, or something, and put your money somewhere. These banks gonna collapse. Don't think it's strange why they closing all the walk-ins, and you can own a drive-through, and but they telling you just use your credit or ATM card. See, they get rid of that paper money. Listen here. I just want to throw that in your spirit. Believe what you want to believe. I don't care. So somebody called me and they seen my video. I heard what I heard. He said, Dedric, he said, it's four churches I want to use to show the world what's going on. It's three churches in Birmingham and the one in Jacksonville. The three churches in Birmingham are on the northwest side of Birmingham. The one in Jacksonville on the northwest side of Jacksonville. He told me the name. And some of the churches I went to, I said, well, God, how you going to lose? See, what I did without knowing, and that's what he's telling me, I went and judged the leadership capability. I said, they like this and that. That don't matter. He just trying to find somewhere that he can really house his glory. You really want to see a Azusa Street? If these churches line up how God want them to line up, y'all going to see something. He said, he said, I want you to watch them. He said, when they begin to do such and such and such and such, he said, I want you to send the pastor this message. Or he said, they're going to invite you. When they invite you, I want you to say this. But if they don't do this, don't you dare go nowhere. Why me, Lord? Watch this. He said, have you ever noticed how you really is? He said, you have had people that came up against you, but you'll still send people to their church. You'll just tell them to watch their attitudes or watch how they do this. God wants to show himself mighty on the earth. But y'all got to get the world out the church. Listen here. I'm going to go watch TV. Y'all ain't studying me. I don't know nothing. Y'all be blessed. Have a good day.